Greetings, my people, on this spectacular Thursday. I'm actually recording this on Wednesday, so doing a little bit of time travel. I'm the only person that can actually time travel. It's pretty interesting. So welcome to my second episode of, I guess this is called Timely News. I didn't want to give it a name, I just wanted to, whenever I made a video, just upload the name of the video, but Charlie wanted it to have a name, so yeah. I know I missed the video last week, I'm sorry, I hope you didn't miss me too much, and I hope it was able to seduce you all. But yeah, here we go, back on track, still got the shitty webcam, and I'm gonna get a new one someday. And yeah, I'm gonna be talking about Call of Duty World War II, and I never thought I would be talking about Call of Duty on this YouTube channel. Well, me and Bill did play Black Ops on that one live stream, that's a whole different story. I know no one probably knows this because I've never said it, but I really don't care about the Call of Duty series. Ever since Black Ops 1, or ever since Black Ops 2 came out, I just kind of stopped caring. That future stuff just isn't for me. I honestly just do not like any of that at all. So whenever I saw rumors that there's going to be a Call of Duty World War II, I'm going to say World at War 2, I was really excited, because I love World War II games, I love just, like, historical stuff in general, and, like, in real life, I'm a bit of a history buff when it comes to World War II. It's just so interesting to me. Probably gonna sound like a nerd, I don't care, I like World War II. And, honestly, there hasn't been a World War II game, like a big budget World War II game in so long. That's why I liked Battlefield 1 a lot, is, I like World War 1 as well, in history, and I just thought that was really unique, because you don't get a lot of World War 1 games, just mainly, like World War 2 or Vietnam. I know there's, like, a few games that do have that time period, but it's not, like a Call of Duty or a Battlefield, it's just, like, smaller stuff. Not saying it's bad, just not as well known. But yeah, I really wasn't expecting... Oh, I don't want to say that. I kind of was expecting this from Call of Duty. Just because... For the past few years, every time a new Call of Duty was coming out, I remember going to my friends saying, like, oh, this is it. It's going to be a historical game. And they're like, yeah, no. And it ended up being something futuristic and just dumb. And whenever they showed off Infinite Warfare, that was just, like, my breaking point. I was just like... Like, there's just no hope anymore for the Call of Duty franchise. And shortly after, they show us Call of Duty World War II, and they had, like, that stream and everything, and showed us a trailer, and I'm just excited. Watching that stream, just them talking about, like, how historically accurate it's going to be for the war, I just think that's really, really good for Call of Duty. That's what it needs right now. Especially because Battlefield 1 is just dominating. It's really nice to see history repeat itself with real wars and stuff that's historical and whatnot. I'm pretty sure, like, the last World War II Call of Duty game was World at War, and that came out in, like, 2008 or 2009, so it's almost close to 10 years. So I'm super excited for it. I hope you guys are too. And it looks like a lot of people are. If you look at the trailer and look at the likes, there's a lot of likes, a lot of positive feedback, but if you compare that to Infinite Warfare, it's a huge improvement. I mean, there was like 3 million dislikes for was it Infinite Warfare? Yeah, it was. And yeah, the only thing is, yeah, I'm super hyped for, you know, this Call of Duty game, but I hope they don't Call of Duty it, which means, like Day Zero Edition DLC with, you know, crazy gun camo and, like, all this stupid stuff. I really hope that they really keep true to this. So, like, I don't want to see any, like, gold camo, diamond, weed emblem tags and stupid stuff like that. Just, that would really just ruin the overall tone and I guess, atmosphere of that war. It would just be pretty stupid for them to do that. So that's my main concern, but this looks really promising, so I guess we'll just have to wait until E3, which is in about a month or so. And yeah, stay tuned next week, and I'm going to talk about E3, basically just like my predictions, what I'm hyped for. And yeah, see you next time. Goodbye.
Hey, how you doing? So you like that video? That's great. You should probably leave a like and a comment to let us know. Probably share it with your friends too, and you know, hit that subscribe button. Make us feel good about ourselves. Alright, thank you.